Okay. Nintendo finally legalizes streaming their games. Nintendo joins the 21st century. Nintendo kills revenue-stealing creators program. Nintendo gives you back your money. Nintendo gets a clue. It's finally over. Nintendo has finally figured it out and joined the 21st century by killing their creators program, a content control program so horrific that it was just a matter of time before they realized it did them more harm than good. Nintendo made the announcement somewhat quietly on Friday, December 1st, saying, quote, "To make it easier for content creators to make and monetize videos that contain Nintendo game content, we will no longer ask creators to submit their videos to the Nintendo Creators Program, and creators can continue to show their passion for Nintendo by following Nintendo's guidelines, which give people permission to monetize videos with gameplay footage of Nintendo games, so long as the content creator adds something to the process." Nintendo says it still plans to enforce its guidelines and will, presumably, pull offending videos from their respective platforms, likely via the DMCA process. There were many problems with the old program. Creators were previously required to register their channel or videos to be allowed to post and monetize their Nintendo content, and even then, they were only eligible to receive a share of advertising revenue from Nintendo. Membership meant granting Nintendo a perpetual, transferable, one-way license to use your Nintendo content-containing videos in any way they want, including promoting, advertising, and marketing games, the program, and Nintendo hardware. None of this seemed to include any consideration for fair use, the copyright, that allows criticism and commentary without any permission being sought or granted by the author of the used material. This means that Nintendo could have faced a real legal challenge if it forcibly monetized or copystruck a video making a proper fair use of Nintendo's content. And that doesn't even begin to touch on how much input a game needs before the output has transformed the original work into a new, protected work. In other words, a game doesn't play itself. I have to move the mouse or the joystick and press the buttons, and most games give me some freedom to choose when and how I do so, how I play the game, meaning the output of the gameplay is not the sole product of the game's creator, but also my creative inputs, blurring the line of ownership of the final copyright on anyone's gameplay. I'll save the rest of that discussion for the comments below. Registering content through the Creator Program also meant Nintendo would take over control of your advertisement revenue on Twitch and YouTube and pay you a portion of the money earned from your videos or channel. This split was 70% to you and 30% to them for registered channels, and 60% you and 40% them for individual videos. Also lifted is the confusion surrounding live streaming on YouTube, with Nintendo previously saying that you could stream Nintendo content, but would have to do so with a different account or register individual videos individually at the lower monetization rate of 60%. We were going to protest this policy in our own little way by hosting an illegal live stream of me playing Nintendo games like this and not showing the screen. Har har. But now that the program is ending, I am somewhat more confident that Nintendo won't copy strike this video, even though I've included legal NES content and Switch content in the background. And that's because Nintendo's content guidelines were updated on November 29th. They now allow you to monetize your videos through Facebook, Niconico, OpenRec.tv, Twitch, Twitter, and YouTube with no other sales or monetization allowed. You are required to add to the gameplay in some creative way, meaning videos or images that are mere copies of game content without any creative input or commentary are not permitted. Nintendo did say that content shared with the capture button on the Switch may be shared without meeting this requirement. In my opinion, interacting with the game pretty much at all meets my minimum standard for creative input, but I can't speak to what Nintendo's exact standard will be. Nintendo says you can only publish gameplay from games that have been released, and you are not permitted to imply any sponsorship or representation of Nintendo. The guidelines, which seem more like requirements, do not apply to corporate entities, with Nintendo explicitly stating that they apply to individuals only. I have no idea what corporate entities are expected to do, so good luck there. I'm assuming this was meant to filter out major corporations, but who knows how it will be enforced. Nintendo says they will still take down videos that violate their policies, including content that violates the law, infringes on Nintendo's copyrights, or features pirated software. I presume this is through the normal DMCA process with a right to appeal, etc., and hopefully after accounting for fair use, as required by Lens for Universal. So, there you have it. No more revenue split, no more granting Nintendo a license, and no more shenanigans around live streaming on YouTube, so long as your content meets the guidelines. The Nintendo Creators Program officially ends December 31st, just in time for the release of Pokemon Let's Go on November 16th and Super Smash Bros. Ultimate on December 7th. Now, if only Nintendo would figure out how badly we would like usable voice chat. Thank you for joining us. This is a community-supported channel brought to you by the over 400 patrons that pledge their monthly support at patreon.com/LJFrench. Special thanks to Justin Rogers for his support at the $500 level. And thank you to Jonathan Doe, John Steele, Gavin Barnard, Kyle Mudrock, Evie Andy Veramentane, William Gonzalez, Michael Pierce, Terry Crisp, Richard Fournier, also known as Breakfast Demon, Spirit Bear Jan Negre, Jax Merrick, and Daniel Perez for your support at the $50 level. And thank you to the over 200 $5 plus supporters. I'll scroll their names here and thank them all for making this whole thing possible. Of course, thank you to all of our other Patreon, Twitch, and YouTube supporters as well. We've ordered our silver play button. We'll have a celebration show sometime soon after it arrives, which YouTube says is only 2 weeks away. We'll see. And Ilsa is healing very well. I'm absolutely ecstatic that she's going to be back to normal by spring. I'm Leonard French, your favorite copyright attorney. I hope you have a great week, and I'll see you this weekend in Super Smash Bros. Bye. Registering content through the Creator Program also meant Nintendo would take over control of your advertising revenue. Advertisementing revenue? It says advertisementing. Registering content through the Creator Program also meant Nintendo would take over control of your I'm sorry, that's too funny. That didn't work. Whew. I can do this. I really can. Registering content through the Creator Program also meant Nintendo would take over control of your advertisement revenue.